sir. How many students are studying CS, sir, in your institute?
Company secretary. We have right now joined five students.
Okay.
That student took classes like personally. He took personal classes 3 months, short term coaching he cleared.
Okay.
And more two also cleared, but they took long term.
Okay.
Yeah, yeah.
Anybody cleared that this time?
3 students cleared, madam.
3 students cleared, sir.
Yes,
okay.
Yes. Group
CS
one.
CS executive also. Group
CS executive model. Okay. Model two, they will be starting.
Yeah.
Okay.
Ma'am is taking, sir.
Madam is taking. That is madam's responsibility because she is a CS, so she takes.
Yeah.
Now, understanding learning curves in forecasting. So, as we have discussed yesterday, forecasting is nothing but prediction of the future. So we have already discussed to forecast, we use a regression model. Now we are speaking about learning curves. We can use learning curves also to forecast company's future. How would we do that? Let's understand. So what is learning curve? Learning curve is nothing but as more and more time you are involved in doing a particular task and more hours or more days or more years you spend on some particular task, performing that task routinely, you would be gaining a lot of experience. And then what happens is, since the amount of time you have spent is nothing but you have learned many things from that particular task, it has enhanced your experience, and we can say that you will become more efficient as more and more experience you gain, and we expect less blunders or less like errors from a person who is experienced. So learning curve is nothing but it is the concept that it refers to some concept that efficiency increases, but how? As the amount of experience a person has with a given task increases. Now, as a result, the time required for performing the task decreases as increases occur in the number of times the task has been performed. So he says that more time you spend on task, okay, less time you will consume subsequently. In the future, to perform the task. Okay, suppose I can tell about myself. I started my teaching long time back when I was a beginner. I used to take a lot of time to convince my students for a particular concept. Not only me, in the entire world, it's the same thing for a beginner. But as the time passed, as more and more number of years passed, my experience, I have like my experience, whatever I have been gaining, and I've become more experienced now. I'm 12 years experienced in teaching and six to seven years experience in professional courses. Now the amount of time I'm taking to convince my students have decreased drastically. Okay, so that is the concept. So, you know, like when you perform some task with more efficiency, you save time and you save cost also, because less wastage and more improvement in the productivity is also seen. So now the two learning curve models are commonly used. One is cumulative average time learning model. Okay, we'll see this. This is based on, when I speak about cumulative, it's 1, 2, 3. If I want to say the cumulative, 1. 1 plus 2, 3. 2 plus 3, 6. This is cumulative. That means when you move the next step, what happens? You take the previous count also. Previous number also. Okay? Now, cumulative average time model is based on assumption that cumulative average time required per unit declines at a constant rate each time the cumulative quantity of units produced doubles. So they say that as you start your production, you double your production only when you become experienced. So they say that the cumulative average time, see, the time would reduce constantly if you double your production, okay? Because as you start producing more and more, since your experience is increasing in some task, you consume less time, correct? Is it so, madam? Hello, are you following? Hello. Madam, are you
yes,
following?
Sir. Yes, yeah. Sir.
So the cumulative average time learning model can be used to estimate the average time per unit required to produce all of given number of units produced. So how much average time you are taking to produce the all number of units, okay? Now, incremental unit time learning model is based on assumption that incremental amount of time required to produce last unit declines. Yeah, as you move forward, the last unit, what you make, you will be consuming the least time to make that unit. Okay, that is the incremental unit time learning model. Now we will understand about that with the help of some practical question that would make you to understand it in a more better way. So all this theory like would be covered there. We'll see what is happening. Limits of learning curve percentages. The learning curve will always be less than 100%, because if the learning curve is 100%, then no learning and no decrease in the time required is taking place. So learning curve is always less than 100%, because learning curve is, if say 100%, then no learning. That means you have completely learned everything now. Now, do you think there is any kind of learning required? No. Since like we have learned 100%, there is no learning required. So it is always less than 100%. So scope of learning is there, and no decrease in time required, because it's taking place, because already you have learned everything. Now, like with more and more time you spend, you come to that level where the time should decrease. Okay. So learning curve percentage.